Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss about klystron, as klystron comes under microwave tubes. So as we discussed yesterday that conventional tubes fails to operate above 1 gigahertz, or we can say in microwave frequency range, because of inter-electrode capacitance, lead capacitance, transit time, gain bandwidth product, skin effect, etc. So for the microwave applications, we generally use microwave tubes. So these are the contents. Microwave tubes classification: multi-cavity klystron, two-cavity klystron, working of two-cavity klystron, characteristics of two-cavity klystron, application of two-cavity klystron, and references. So if we talk about microwave tubes, they are generally used due to the limitation of conventional tubes at high frequency, and these are widely used in microwave applications. Generally, microwave tubes are of two types. First one is linear beam type, that is also called O type, and second one is cross field tubes, or generally called M types. Linear beam tubes are in which DC magnetic field is in parallel with the DC electric field, and in case of cross field tubes, DC magnetic fields and DC electric fields are perpendicular to each other. So let's see the classification. Microwave tubes are, as already said, that they are linear beam devices and cross field devices. Linear beam devices are resonant cavity devices, and cross field devices are magnetron and CFA. As we discuss in this section, we will discuss about linear beam devices. So linear beam devices are resonant cavity and slow wave structure, that are non-resonant. Why we use slow wave structure? Because these type of structure are used to slow down the electromagnetic waves. Why it is necessary to slow down the electromagnetic waves? To increase the time of interaction of electron, we need to decrease the velocity of EM wave. So as today's topic is klystron amplifier, that comes under the linear beam device. Okay, and another type of linear resonant cavity is reflex klystron, that we will discuss in the later topics. Okay, first let's come to the klystron. What is klystron? Klystron tube is a vacuum tube that can be operated either as an oscillator or as an amplifier at microwave frequency. So how it can be works as amplifier or oscillator? So if you talk about multi-cavity klystron, in case of multi-cavity klystron, it works as microwave amplifier, and in case of reflex klystron, it works as low power microwave oscillators. In case of multi-cavity klystron, we generally use two cavity klystron and three cavity klystrons. Okay, so multi-cavity klystrons are low power microwave amplifiers. So for the calculation of multi-cavity klystron, we use some assumptions, that are, first one is transit time in the cavity gap is very small compared to the period of the input RF signal, and second one is the input RF signal amplitude is very small compared to the DC beam voltage. The first and second assumption are used to neglect the back and forth movement of electron in the cavity gap. Third assumption is the field are totally confined in the cavity gap and zero in the drift space. Fourth one is electron leave the cathode with zero initial वेलोसिटी, एंड फिफ्थ वन इज स्पेस चार्ज इफेक्ट्स आर नेग्लिजिबल. सो लेट्स कम टू टू कैविटी क्लिस्ट्रॉन्स. टू कैविटी क्लिस्ट्रॉन आर मोस्ट वाइडली यूज्ड माइक्रोवेव एम्पलीफायर. ओके, इट वर्क्स ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वेलोसिटी एंड करंट मॉड्यूलेशन. ओके, जनरली देर आर टू कैविटीज इन टू कैविटी क्लिस्ट्रॉन. टू कैविटीज आर यूज. फर्स्ट वन इज कॉल्ड इनपुट कैविटी एंड सेकेंड वन इज आउटपुट कैविटी. इनपुट कैविटी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड बंचर कैविटी एंड आउटपुट कैविटी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड कैचर कैविटी. दैट इज द बेसिक डायग्राम ऑफ टू कैविटी क्लिस्ट्रॉन. दिस कैथोड, देन बंचर कैविटी और इनपुट कैविटी विच इज कनेक्टेड. बंचर कैविटी इज कनेक्टेड टू आर एफ इनपुट एंड कैचर कैविटी विच इज ऑल्सो कनेक्टेड टू आर एफ आउटपुट. द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू इज एल. सो लेट्स सी हाउ इट works. Okay, at first and there is a cathode. The electron enters or electron injected from this cathode. Electron injected from cathode with a uniform velocity. So how we will calculate this velocity? By equating the potential energy and the kinetic energy of the electron. The potential energy can be calculated by the multiplication of E and V naught. What is E? Whether is E is the charge of the electron and V naught is the voltage of across cathode. And how we can calculate kinetic energy? Kinetic energy calculated by the formula of half m v square. Okay, where m is mass of electron and v is velocity. So by equating potential energy and kinetic energy, we can calculate the velocity of uniform electron. That is V naught equal to half under root of 2 E V naught by m meter per second, where E is electron charge, V naught is voltage given at cathode input, and m is mass of electron. In the first cavity, the velocity of these electrons will be modulated by the RF signal present in the first cavity. This is called velocity modulation. Okay. Now, these modulated electrons, okay, these modulated electrons which are formed by velocity modulation forms bunches. This is called bunch formation. And because of this bunch formation, the density of electron in the catcher cavity varies periodically with the time. That means the electron beam contains AC component of the current. That is known as current modulation. Okay, so as I said that it works in the voltage and current modulation principle of current voltage and current modulation. So this is current modulation and voltage modulation. So after passing through second cavity, all the electrons will give up their kinetic energy to microwave fields present at the second cavity, and because of that their velocity will reduce and they will be collected at collector. Okay, after the catcher cavity, they will be collected at collector. So suppose if the average time to reach at bunch cavity is T naught and average time to leave the cavity is T1, then transit time can be calculated as tau is equal to T naught minus T1. And if the gap of this cavity is D, okay, then transit time can be calculated as T1 minus T0 is equal to D by V0 as distance upon velocity. And transit angle can be calculated as omega tau, where tau is D by V0, so omega D by V0.